This is the Catholic Daily Mass Readings and Reflections for Saturday of the third week of Easter season. Today's first reading is from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, verses 31 to 42. And Gospel reading is from John, chapter 6, verses 60 to 69. Thanks for joining today's Mass Readings and Reflections. If you are new to this channel, please consider subscribing to this channel and don't forget to like the video and share it with your friends and family. First reading, a reading from the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 9, verses 31 to 42. The church throughout all Judea and Galilee and Samaria had peace and was built up. And walking in the fear of the Lord and in the comfort of the Holy Spirit, it was multiplied. Now, as Peter went here and there among them all, he came down also to the saints that lived at Lydda. There he found a man named Aeneas, who had been bedridden for 8 years and was paralyzed. And Peter said to him, "Aeneas, Jesus Christ heals you. Rise and make your bed." And immediately he rose, and all the residents of Lydda and Sharon saw him, and they turned to the Lord. Now there was at Joppa a disciple named Tabitha, which means Dorcas or Gazelle. She was full of good works and acts of charity. In those days she fell sick and died. And when they had washed her, they laid her in an upper room. Since Lydda was near Joppa, the disciples, hearing that Peter was there, sent two men to him entreating him, "Please come to us without delay." So Peter rose and went with them. And when he had come, they took him to the upper room. All the widows stood beside him weeping, and showing coats and garments which Dorcas made while she was with them. But Peter put them all aside and knelt down and prayed. Then turning to the body, he said, "Tabitha, rise." And she opened her eyes, and when she saw Peter, she sat up, and he gave her his hand and lifted her up. Then calling the saints and widows, he presented her alive. And it became known throughout all Joppa, and many believed in the Lord. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Response Oriel Psalm. Your response: how shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? How shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? The cup of salvation I will take up, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Your response: how shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? My vows to the Lord I will pay in the presence of all his people. Precious in the eyes of the Lord is the death of his faithful ones. Your response: how shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? O Lord, I am your servant. I am your servant, the son of your handmaid. You have loosed my bonds. To you will I offer sacrifice of thanksgiving, and I will call upon the name of the Lord. Your response: how shall I make a return to the Lord for all the good he has done for me? Gospel acclamation. Alleluia, Alleluia. Your words, Lord, are spirit and life. You have the words of everlasting life. Alleluia, Alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John, chapter 6, verses 60 to 69. Many of his disciples, when they heard it, said, "This is a hard saying. Who can listen to it?" But Jesus, knowing in himself that his disciples murmured at it, said to them, "Do you take offense at this? Then what if you were to see the Son of Man ascending where he was before? It is the Spirit that gives life. The flesh is of no avail. The words that I have spoken to you are the spirits and life. But there are some of you that do not believe." For Jesus knew from the first who those were that did not believe, and who it was that would betray him. and he said, "This is why I told you that no one can come to me unless it is granted him by the Father." After this, many of his disciples drew back and no longer walked with him. Jesus said to the 12, "Will you also go away?" Simon Peter answered him, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life, and we have believed and have come to know that you are the Holy One of God." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Dear brothers and sisters, in today's first reading, we read, Saint Peter heals a paralyzed man named Aeneas and raised a lady named Tabitha from death. Here in the first miracle we see, Saint Peter takes the initiative. He does not wait for the paralyzed man to seek his help. We are told about the man being sick for 8 years to show how difficult he was to cure. And yet, through the power of Jesus Christ, he is cured immediately. Why did Peter not wait for the man to show his faith? Why did he not first ask him if he wanted to be cured? Surely, because it was necessary to impress the people by means of this miracle. The miracle of the raising of Tabitha by Peter is the first one of its kind reported in Acts. Here, as in the Gospel, miracles are performed to awaken faith in those who witness them, with good dispositions and a readiness to believe. In this case, the miracle is a kindness God shows Tabitha to reward her virtues, and an encouragement to the Christians of Joppa. The conversion of the people of Lydda, Sharon and Joppa were also the result of Peter's work. Miracles are not designed to make life easier for the apostles. Their tireless preaching is by no means secondary or superfluous. Today in the Gospel we see, followers of Jesus abandon him. This is the only instance in the Gospel where followers of Jesus abandon him in such large numbers. They found his teaching too difficult to accept and decided to leave his company. Here we notice, throughout this discourse, Jesus did not attempt to rephrase his words in order to clear up any misunderstanding. This indicates that he was not speaking metaphorically. He meant what he said about his body and blood being real food and drink. He would be likewise unequivocal when he instituted the sacrament of the Eucharist at the Last Supper. As the representative of the believers, Simon Peter spoke in proclaiming their fidelity to Christ and their belief in his identity as the Holy One of God. Even if they did not fully understand Jesus' teaching with the words, "Lord, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life, and we have believed and have come to know that you are the Holy One of God," Peter made the fundamental statement for belief in Christ. In every Eucharist, we firmly proclaim the faith in Christ. Jesus is present during the Holy Mass. As the liturgy of the word, he exhorts us and encourages us. Then he gives his flesh and blood to us in the breaking of the bread. With a firm faith, let us approach this great mystery and receive Jesus into our lives wholeheartedly. May God bless you all.